Good day, folks. My name's Raymond Moore, and I'm here with the RV Corral in beautiful Eugene, Oregon. Winnebago has just recently got back into the travel trailer fifth wheel business, and as you can see, this is the Winnebago Light 5 series. It's a 26 with the rear kitchen model, and we're going to do a little bit of show and tell today, so bear with me, and I hope you enjoy the video. Aluminum frame construction. As you can see, we have the high gloss gel coat finish, which is really nice. I have an enclosed switch area for my power jacks instead of just having them out on the outside where any little boy or girl can come along and play around with them. And if you notice in the front compartment area in here, I do have a separation from this area into my storage area, which is, we'll show you in a minute, which is really nice, so things can't fall through from the storage area into this area. We do put it with two deep cycle Interstate batteries, and this unit has what they call the slam latch, which is the nicer units as far as the compartments go. As you can see, folks, it's a full pass-through storage area, nicely finished. On the outside, we have a 6-gallon hot water heater. We have the outside utility shower up in here. And by the way, all the tanks are fully enclosed, and as long as you've got the furnace on, you do not have to worry about any kind of freezer. Slide out, which really doesn't do too much here, except we do have the outside for the 8-cubic-foot refrigerator on the inside. So I have power jacks in the front. I have manual stabilizer jacks in the back end. 30-amp marine grade. Marine grade just means that it hooks on from the outside. I don't have to try and feed the cord into a little tiny box compartment area on the inside. I have my square tube bumper on the back, which normally people will pop this cap off and carry their sewer hose. Ladder going up onto the roof, and that is a full walk-on roof up there, folks. It's a rubberized, and you can see it's a radius roof. Spare tires on the back end. Furnace is right here at the back end too. Now on the curbside, we have the power awning, which covers the entrance door. And over here, we have the largest storage compartment going in from this side, and I want to show it to you because it is a decent sized storage compartment. So what we do, folks, and when we sell them, we completely fill the propane, we double check them as far as a PDI, safety check them, go through all systems, and then we give you what we refer to as a new owner's school, to where the service mechanic completely goes through it with you. One thing I like about this floor plan is basically you have your dining table on the curb side. So if you have your awning outside and you have your deck chairs out there and your picnic table, you're looking always at your stuff. And many manufacturers put the dining area on the driver's side and you're never looking at your stuff. We have some dark safety tinted windows on the outside. And I have jalousie windows. If you folks are not familiar with jalousie windows, the jalousie windows open this way instead of slide. So on a day like today, we can leave these open, we can leave the trailer, we don't have to worry about anybody breaking in. If it rains, we don't have to worry about it because the rain isn't going to come through, it's going to go off the window to the outside. So I have jalousie windows on this side too. And I have a jalousie window in the back end. Sectional sofa, really nice. I have an 8-cubic-foot upgraded refrigerator, pantry storage right by the fridge. And look at that counter space in the back end. That is really nice. Couple more drawers, storage underneath the sink, microwave, 3-burner stovetop with an oven. A little bit different. We have ducted air conditioning in the ceiling, which is pretty much standardized in this day and age. Nice clothes, jacket area to hang your coats up with. It does come with a flat screen TV, which we have out right now. AM, FM, stereo, DVD player down below. Curtis, let's go up. It's kind of tight quarters there. Hand railing going up into the bathroom, bedroom area. Door goes in. Nice little area there, garden shower, china stool. And I'm going to go ahead of Curtis because this one has the closet slide and open some doors for him when he comes in here. to the bedroom. And I will change places with Curtis, so we can give you a good view of those closets. The closets are on a slide out over there. And I did mention we do have ducted air conditioning, so I have air conditioning ducted into my bedroom plus the heat as well. Little storage area there in the front, a couple of drawers on either side. And then because the bed doesn't slide out, we have a nice storage area down below. And on most fifth wheels, you normally see the bed sliding out, and this one is just a little bit different on the floor plan. So we're not sitting in our living room looking through at our bathroom with this particular floor plan. It's a great floor plan, folks. We have many others that Winnebago do. This is just one of them that I'm presenting to you today. We don't take a long time where we bore you to death with these videos. We hope we keep you entertained a little bit. But I'm Raymond Moore with the RV Corral in Eugene, Oregon. What'll come up will be my phone number, my email address. Call me, stop by, have a cup of coffee. Love to visit with you. Raymond Moore, RV Corral. Thanks for watching the video. Have a great day.